We have Sapnesh Lalla of the CEO of NIIT Ltd who's joining us on the show. Sapnesh, thanks for taking the time out. We're looking at some very steady earnings coming on for NIIT Technology. NIIT Limited, and these are largely in line with what we were working with in terms of expectations too. Let me start off with your performance in terms of the corporate learning group. How are you seeing things pan out here? Because we're looking at 17% growth on a year-on-year basis, and that's quite healthy. Are we expecting further strength in this particular segment going forward as well?
Absolutely. So from an overall perspective, like you pointed out, we've seen 10% growth at the NIIT level. The corporate business has done really well. The growth is 17%. In volume terms, on constant currency basis, the growth was 18%. So the corporate business has done really well, and we expect that it will continue to perform at an accelerated clip on a go-forward basis.
So Sapnesh,
it added two new managed training services customers in the last quarter, and also expanded its contract with a couple of existing customers.
Right, Sapnesh, my question then is that, considering you guys are expanding and the way NIIT Limited is moving on, are there further investments which are in place right now? And in that case, do you think that these further investments may have some sort of a near-term impact on operational profits?
See, I think we are considering a number of investments. We are considering both organic as well as inorganic investments, specifically in the areas that are key pillars of growth, namely our corporate business, as well as in India, our stack route and our talent pipeline as a service business. So we are considering investments in these areas, both organic as well as inorganic. In terms of how it might affect our operational performance on a go-forward basis, I think the quantum of investment and the timing of investment will tell. Suffice it to say so far, I think we are making strategic choices in terms of making investments, and each of these investments are aimed at accelerating growth for the company.
Okay, Sapnesh, I suppose that when it comes to your acquisitions, you can't really tell us any more about what you're looking at, but can you at least give us an idea about the kind of ticket size this acquisition may be? And it could even be a very large range if it's possible for you to do so.
We typically look at organizations in the $20 to $40 million range, global organizations. Our goal in terms of acquisitions is and has always been to improve capability as well as geographic or market reach. So that's sort of the range that we play in.
All right, Sapnesh, from a very macro-oriented perspective, we are not exactly seeing the best of scenarios when it comes to jobs in the country. My question then is, when it comes to training services, what is your current outlook? And I know that you guys operate in some very niche segments. That said, if you could still give us an idea about the kind of traction that you are witnessing, the kind of conversations that you are having with your clients.
Sure, happy to. I think we have two points of view on it. The first one is that given the amount of turbulence and the number of disruptions that you're seeing, technology oriented as well as to some extent environmental, more and more corporations are looking at focusing on what they do best, focusing on their core competences. And they're looking for organizations who can do training for them. In fact, who can do training for them much better than they can do themselves, because all of them are looking at the future of work being very different from what it is today. So they are looking at specialist organizations who can help them mold their workforce to be ready for the future while they are able to focus on their core operations. So I think that's one key point of view. I think the second key point of view is to take advantage of the technological disruptions that are taking place. Organizations like technology companies, organizations who are building technology-oriented products, organizations who are key users of technology, for example, banks, insurance companies, life sciences organizations, they're trying to figure out how to transform the talent that they have, especially the technology talent that they have, so that those folks can drive change, drive transformation, build new products that could enable them to address the future a lot better. So from both of these points of view, I think we are seeing significant demand for our services. And I think we are well positioned both in India as well as globally to take advantage of these trends.
Okay, fair enough, Sapnesh. We leave it at that. Thank you so much for joining us and talking to us here on Bloomberg Quint.